move your army into the direction of Egypt. And I will send you a letter telling you what to do. Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu was one of the most clever men Muslims have ever seen. He moved into the direction of Egypt. This was the 18th year of Hijrah. A messenger, before he entered Egypt, a messenger came from Umar ibn al-Khattab with a message. Amr ibn al-As refused to receive the message. He said, wait, I will take the message later on. He said, this is a message from the Khalifa. He said, I know, wait. I will meet with you later. And he kept moving. And the messenger wanted to meet with him and he was refused. Until Amr ibn al-As crossed the border of Egypt. Then he said, let the messenger see me. He took the message from the messenger, and the message from the Khalifa Umar ibn al-Khattab said to Amr ibn al-As, if you have crossed the border of Egypt, continue. If you have not, come back. See, very clever. So Amr ibn al-As sent to him, we have crossed. We are ready to conquer Egypt, but I have only 4,000 men with me. Only 4,000. The number of fighting men, according to statistics of that time. How do we know the statistics of that time? Those non-Muslims would pay jizya. Instead of zakat, they would pay jizya. Only fighting men. Women don't pay it. Old men and children don't pay it. Only fighting men. Umar ibn al-Khattab later on sends to Amr ibn al-As. He said, count for me how many pay jizya. This is in the seerah. Amr ibn al-As sends him back that the number of men, fighting men, paying jizya is alfa alf. Million. 1 million. He was attacking 1 million with only 4,000. So he sent a letter to Umar. Said, I have only 4,000. Send me some more fighting men. So he sent him. He did not have enough armies. I mean, the Muslims were very few. The armies were already in Syria and Palestine, and they were conquered. The armies were already reaching India. They were covering all of this. And the total number of the Muslim army that is conquering this whole area, the total number was about 60,000. In all lands. So where can I find men for you? So he started to collect the Bedouins and whatever did not go for jihad. Go to Egypt. So he sent to him, I have sent you a supply of 8,000 men. Amr ibn al-As counted the Muslims that came from Medina, and they were only 4,000. So he sent him a letter back. He said, where is the rest? You said 8,000. He said, among the 4,000 are 4 men. Each counts as 1,000. Muhammad ibn Maslama, Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, Ubad ibn al-Samit, wal-Muqdad ibn al-Aswad. Radiyallahu anhu. Do we see now men that count for 1,000?
One over 1,000.
Most men today don't add up to one. Each was counted as 1,000. Now, the whole army was 8,000 facing Egypt with its huge civilization. Add to that the Roman army with the Roman fleet of ships in Alexandria with direct contact with Istanbul. Strong in military, strong in civilization, strong in everything. He was not facing weak people. Egypt was one of the strongest nations on earth and governed by the Romans. How long did it take Amr ibn al-As to conquer Egypt and enter Alexandria, its capital? For not years, 4 months. Only 4 months. What is this? What happens to these civilizations, these superpowers, that they think they have the world order in hand? They control the world. They can attack anyone, anywhere. What happened to them? They collapse so quickly. Why? Some of you might say this is the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, the true religion. No, that's not only that. Let's take another situation. Let's talk years after that. The first attack on the Spanish Empire by the Muslims was in the year 92 of Hijrah. No companions. Led by a non-Arab. Led by Tariq ibn Ziyad, who was not an Arab. And he was not definitely a companion. 92 was the first attack. 95, they finished Spain and Portugal. And they were already attacking France. 1 year later, Muslims were only 60 kilometers from Paris. What happened to this civilization? 3 years it collapsed. What happened to the French? They could not stop the Muslims. They almost reached their capital. What happened? We're not talking hundreds of years or tens, brothers and sisters. We're talking 2 years here, 3 years here, 3 years here, 1 year here. What's this? There is a secret. There's something common that is going on in all of these civilizations. All of these civilizations collapsed because of two things. Not one, two. Always two things. The first one was moral destruction within. They had no morals. They were corrupt from inside. They were corrupt morally, materialistic world, sexual relations, family structure destructed, individualism. This is very similar to what we see in the Western civilization today. But that is by itself, it was not enough to make them collapse. Because they were corrupt for years and years. That by itself is not enough to collapse a civilization. There must be another reason, and the other reason is a better civilization or a stronger civilization attacking them, challenging them. Either they are better or they are stronger, materialistically speaking. Either better morally or stronger materialistically. And that's why we saw the Mongolians conquering Europe. They were not better morally. The Mongolians were all